Hello, everybody. This is Mike Falco coming back to you for Apollo once again. Just a little bit of housekeeping here. So I recently launched a newsletter that I'll put in the comments. Every Friday, I'll be reviewing three different SaaS/AI tools that are specifically related to the SDR, BDR kind of framework and process. So check that out. I'm excited about it. Apollo's obviously in our first edition. So let me know what you think. Alrighty, so today we're going to do something a little bit different. Instead of a tutorial, I'm going to just give you guys my ideal sequence. I've worked with over 10 companies on building out their SDR process and setting up their Apollo sequences. Everyone is different. Every strategy is going to tailor to different personas and different ICPs and different TAMs. But in terms of if I were to put together a sequence without knowing too much about your business in particular, this is how I would think about it. I would come over to create a new sequence. I don't like any of the pre-formatted ones. No offense, Apollo. Still really love you, but just not super into the formatted sequences, and it's not an Apollo issue. It's just a general issue. I think they're a bit wordy and a little bit duplicitous. Alrighty, so sequence name, we're going to call this Mike's Favorite Sequence Ever. All right, normal business hours, that's good for now. Alrighty, so let's just talk about the strategy here. So A, times have changed a good bit. Around 6 years ago, when I had a team of 23, we would literally load up as many templated automated emails as possible, let them rip, and we would get results. I think people's guard is a lot more up these days. I also know that email servers' guards are a lot stricter and tighter. So I'm going to do a whole nother kind of class or tutorial category on email deliverability, because pretty sure that that's where 90% of teams fall flat. And if we're doing a ton of manual work and we're getting only 80% of our emails into inboxes, then we're wasting a lot of time and we don't want to do that. Alrighty, so back to it. Let's talk about this flow and how I think we should reach out to people. I don't like bombarding prospects with multi-channel outreach within the same day. Obviously, multi-channel outreach is crucial. And if you're in a kind of single channel right now, I think you're probably in trouble. So let's talk about how we do this. And like I mentioned in my video around LinkedIn, this just got a lot easier too. Okay, so step one, I love a manual email on step one. 30 minutes after the contact is added, medium priority is fine. Add a note. So stand out from other sellers, identify a personal trait / characteristic about your prospects. But, and this is the biggest but, telling somebody that you saw on their LinkedIn that they like parasailing does not help you book a meeting if you're selling translation software, right? What you're personalizing on has to tie in to what you're talking about. Now, that's the bare minimum, right? So if you want to do that and then say, hey, I noticed that we both went to Villanova, or hey, I noticed that we both live in New York, right? That's all well and good, but that's not personalization. That's not rapport building. That's I know how to scrape the web or point out kind of random facts about you, right? So my point here is, and let me give you an example, if I could just think of one really quickly. So let's say that somebody's profile, I don't know. Let's say somebody's profile mentioned something about public speaking, right? And you have some kind of hybrid event software, right? That's what you would try to tie in, right? You wouldn't try to tie in that the person had a 22-year tenure at Intel because they're not related, right? Be very direct in how you're making those connections and why you're not reaching out completely cold. If you throw out random facts, right, that you spent time finding, you're actually getting the worst of both worlds. You're getting the lack of a connection based on how you can help them, right? It almost is just a creepy little point that I, you know, found. But you're also, sorry about that. Okay. So you're also wasting your time, right? You're not getting any added benefit out of the work that you're doing, and it's taking you a lot more time. That sounds like a lose-lose. Okay, let's keep moving. So I like a manual email on day one. Now, the company I'm working with right now is called Prime Hire. They are an engineering services temporary placement agency. So you could see here with Apollo, and this is kind of what I was talking about in an earlier video. I do like the idea of using AI for email copy. I do not like the idea of using AI exclusively for your email copy. It's just not there yet. And let's just see what they come up with. I pre-filled this information just so that I wouldn't waste everybody's time. And let's see how we do. Can take up to a minute. Okay. So from what I've seen here, right, their subject lines are actually pretty strong, right? It's just that, and their email copy is getting better, right? It, when they first released this, it was just very long, a lot of paragraphs. So it seems like they're doing a pretty good job of getting to the bottom of this. However, let's just read it. I noticed that company has been struggling with missing product releases due to headcount gaps in your engineering team. If I'm a head of engineering, A, don't insult me without knowing my actual business, right? That's a hell of an assumption to say that you've been struggling missing product releases. What if they haven't? What if they've just been, you know, lean and mean and you know, have been getting things done but can't burn their existing team out, right? That's probably about as likely as them missing deadlines. So again, the point here, guys, is A, they tried, right? Because they tried to loop in a pain point with the solution that Prime Hire solves, right? What they didn't do is leave this as a reverse. They left it as a declarative statement. That makes a huge difference here, right? This should sound like, I noticed a few open roles on the engineering team. Just curious, is that having any effect on your ability to hit your product release due dates, right? That simple, but just look, think about the difference that makes right there. Okay, so this is gonna be a couple part video here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and end it now.